Dear students, today we will discuss on cultivation practices of cotton. Cotton is a soft, fluffy, staple fiber that grows in a ball around the seeds of the cotton plants. It is one of the most important fiber and cash crop of India. It provides the basic raw material to the textile industry. Cotton seed oil is also used by many fast food chains for deep frying. It is a member of Malvaceae family, genus Gossypium. Number of chromosome is 26. There are so many species of Gossypium, but out of these, there are four cultivated species of cotton: Gossypium arboreum, Gossypium herbaceum, Gossypium hirsutum, and Gossypium barbendus. Gossypium arboreum is an Indian cotton. Is called a basic pass. Gossypium arboreum has a shuttering problem, and Gossypium hirsutum is an American cotton, is also called Nerma, and here Nerma means soft. And next, BT cotton. Here BT means Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria. BT cotton has been genetically modified by the inserting one or more genes from common source bacterium. These genes encode for the production of insecticidal proteins. And next, fiber length of cotton are divided into short staple, medium staple, and long staple. Short staple less than 24.6 mm, medium is 24.6 to 30.9 mm, long staples are more than 30.9 mm. In India, there are 10 major cotton growing states: are Gujarat, Maharashtra, and Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Haryana, Rajasthan, and Punjab. American cotton was grown on 2.63 lakh hectares in Punjab during 2018-19. The total production was 12.06 lakh bales with an average yield of 7.79 quintals lint per hectare or 3.15 quintals lint per acre. Next, climatic requirement. A daily minimum temperature of 16 degrees centigrade is required for germination and 21 degrees centigrade to 27 degrees for proper growth or during vegetation period. During the fruiting phase, the day temperature ranging from 27 to 32 degrees centigrade and cool nights are needed. The cotton picking period from mid-September to November must have bright sunny days to ensure a good quality of the produce. And that is soil. Soil should be well textured and rich in organic matter with neutral pH, well drained and leveled. Our cotton can be successfully grown on all soils except sandy, saline or waterlogged types. Proper drainage of excess water during rain is essential. This is improved varieties. BT cotton, PAU BT 1, it is the first BT cotton variety developed by any public sector with inbuilt resistance against American spotted and pink bollworm in the country. Grow BT cotton hybrids recommended by Punjab Agricultural University. Every year, the list of recommended BT cotton hybrids published in PAU publications such as Changi Kheti or Progressive Farmers. And next will be non-BT cottons. F2228. This variety released in during 2015. Its maturity period is 180 days with an average seed cotton yield of 7.4 quintal per acre. It is moderately resistant to jessic and bacterial blight. And second non-BT variety is F2383. It also released in 2015. And this is suitable for sowing under high density plantation system. The variety has medium sized super okra leaves. It matures in about 160 days and its average yield is 7.9 quintal per acre. The next one is LH2108 or Ludhiana hybrid. It released in 2013. It matures in 160 to 170 days with an average seed cotton yield of 8.4 quintal per acre. And next is agronomic practices, subsoiling. This is done by tractor plant subsoil at slope to depth of 45 to 50 centimeter. First, cotton have deep rooted crops. give planking to break the floors and then prepare fine seed bed. Fine seed bed is essential for securing a good plant stand. It's a time of sowing. Sow the crop during 1st of 15 May. Sowing during this period ensure better yield, escape the attack of insect pest and disease. Sowing should be done in morning or evening time. And as well, seed rate. Use following quantity of seeds for BT variety such as PA BT 1, 4 kg BT cotton and plus 1 kg non BT. Grow non BT cotton as it refuse around BT cotton variety harvest to avoid double metal resistance in gold variety BT toxins. And for BT hybrids, all recommended hybrids 900 gram BT seeds and 240 gram non BT seeds, non BT hybrids such as LHH 144. It's a seed rate approximately, the seed rate should be approximately 1.5 kg per acre. And for non BT varieties such as F2028, LH2108, and LH2076, it requires 3.5 kg seed rate. And for F2383 variety, seed rate is required so approximately 6 kg. Seed treatment and seed soaking. Soak the seed in a solution of 0.5 grams succinic acids and 5 liters of water for 2 to 4 hours in case of acid diluted seeds and 6 to 8 hours in case of non diluted seeds. In case of acid diluting of seed, mix 10 gram commercial grade concentrated sulfuric acid with 1 kg cotton seeds. Provide the development of resistance in ball worm to BT cotton. 20% area should be sown under non BT cotton hybrids around BT cottons. Sowing and spacing. Sow in line 67.5 cm apart with the cotton sowing drill. The plants of variety within row be kept 60 cm apart during thinning, whereas PAU BT1 plants with rows be kept 45 cm apart. However, the hybrid, both BT and non BT, the plant distance should be kept at 75 cm. Plant to plant spacing of 15 cm should be kept for variety F2383. And next one is weed control. Hoeing. Hoe the crop 2 or 3 times in first hoeing should be done before first irrigation. Use tractor mounted cultivators or wheel hand hoe for weeding. Their use after fruiting should be avoided. And next one is chemical control. For control of weeds, particularly its seed, madana, makla, apply 1 liter per acre stomp or pendimethalins. Stomp is a trade name and pendimethalin is a chemical name. As per emergence within 24 hours of sun. Spray 500 ml per acre heat weed max 10 mag by dissolving in 150 liters of water after first irrigation. Fertilizer application. Apply fertilizer on soil test basis. The fertilizer recommendations for medium fertility soil are as under. For non-BT variety, this is that nitrogen 30 kg per acre and P2 12 kg per acre. And for BT variety, nitrogen approximately 37, and for BT hybrid and BT non BT hybrid 42 kg nitrogen required per acre. Apply 20 kg urea potash, 6.5 kg zinc sulfate monohydrate, and 4 kg borax as per acre to boron deficient soil at the time of sowing. Except nitrogen fertilizer, all fertilizer should be applied at the time of sowing. But nitrogen fertilizer should be applied in 2 to 3 separate, 1/3 at the time of sowing, 1/3 at the time of first irrigation, and remaining should be applied during second irrigation. If standing crop suffers from deficiency of micronutrients, then we will apply by spraying in liquid form. Irrigation and drainage. Water requires 4 to 6 irrigation depending on the seasonal rainfall. The first irrigation should be given 4 to 6 weeks after sowing and the subsequent ones at interval of 2 or 3 weeks. The crop must not be allowed to suffer from water stress during the flowering and fruiting stages. Otherwise, a lot of shedding of flowers and buds will take place, resulting in low yield. Cotton during its early growth is very sensitive to water stagnation. Therefore, drain out the stagnant water if such a situation arises. Question bowl opening is the last irrigation by the end of September. Next is plant protection. Insect pest, second pest insect, such as whitefly, chestnut, mealybug, thrips, all are sucking types. These mouthparts are sucking types. They suck the juice from the plants, are most serious, and they are most serious for Bt cotton, and they cause maximum damage during July, September. The decision regarding spray of insecticide should be taken based on economic threshold level. Economic threshold level is the population density of insect at which control measures should be applied, and economic injury level is the lowest pest population which will cause economic damage. The decision regarding spray of insecticide should be taken based on economic ETL level. Use low cost yellow sticky traps or pheromone traps at the rate of 40 per acre during initial phase of cotton to check early infestation of whitefly, because whitefly is responsible for viral disease. There are some major insect pest of cotton. Number one is whitefly, thrips, mealybug, pink bollworm, American bollworm, spotted bollworm. Insecticides for the management of insect pest in cotton. Insect, whitefly, insecticide Pulala is a trade name of Flunicamid, which should be applied at the rate of 80 kg per acre. Polo and craze are trade name of diafenthiuron, which should be applied approximately 200 grams. And next is mealybug. Mealybug is controlled by 500 ml Bupropion. And next, thrips. Thrips controlled by 500 ml per acre Curacron or Profenophos. Pink and spotted bollworm. Pink and spotted bollworms are chewing type mouthparts. These are controlled by 100 ml Merit Alpha 10 EC. Merit Alpha is a trade name of alpha methrin. And next is American bollworm. For control of American bollworm, we should apply 60 ml Tris or spinosad or 200 ml Avant or Indexocarb. Do not repeat the insecticide of same group in subsequent supply. Destroy alternate host of cotton whitefly, leaf curl virus, and mealybug. And next one is disease. All of us, leaf curl. Leaf curl is a viral disease, and this is caused by transmitted virus. And the disease plant becomes stunted and have twisted internodes. Leaves remain small, show cupping and curling. And next one is paravilt. Paravilt is a physiological disorder and no pathogen is involved. It also called sudden wilt. It generally occurs after drought when the crop is heavily irrigated and there is heavy range. Plants show sudden drooping of leaves which ultimately get wilted. And there are some photographs of leaf curl and paravilt disease. And next one is root rot. This disease is caused by Rhizoctonia solanae. This is a bacterial disease. The main symptoms are drying and shedding of leaves, leading to complete wilting and death of the plant. And next is bacterial blight. Bacterial blight is also a bacterial disease. It's caused by Xanthomonas maliaceae, which survives in seed and plant dead leaves. Lesson 1, the leaves appear as minute water spots, annular spots. Battle is also called annular leaf spots. And there are some photographs of root rot cotton and bacterial blights. And next is Tilk. It is a physiological disorder. It is characterized by yellowing and reddening of leaves, followed by the bad opening of the bulbs. The attack is more pronounced in the dry belt adjoining Rajasthan and Haryana. It is particularly serious in pockets where cotton suffers from persistent drought, inadequate water supply, nutrient deficiency on light, sandy soils. And this is a photograph of Tilk disease. And next is disease control measures. All of us, disease, leaf curl, protect the group against the white fly, uproot and destroy the disease plant. And leaf, of course, white fly is a main vector of leaf curl virus. All viral disease spread through white fly. White fly work as a vector viral disease. Paramyxoid is also called sudden wilt. Bacterial blight and root rot both are a bacterial disease, so we should treat the seeds. And in the end, picking cotton should be picked clean and dry to get a good price in the market. Picking should be done after every 15 to 20 days to avoid loss because of the kapas falling to the ground. Indian cotton requires more number of picking over American cotton. Do not keep the picked cotton in wet water channels in the field, as this practice impairs the quality of cotton stored kapas in the dry woven. Keep a dose of different varieties separately. Soon after the last picking, remove the cotton sticks along with the roots from the field. And in the end, stay home.